Okay. Right. Come on in, welcome. Oh, I forgot to do this. Done. There we go. Okay. What's up, y'all? How goes it? No, what's that? Why does my computer do that? Okay, get those off of there. So, hello, how are y'all? Getting this fixed up. So, I've got a podcast today, baby. A podcast, yeah, it's gonna be great. Now, I've got to get set up, and I'm doing that right now with you. Since I got my new MacBook, I've got all kinds of different hookups and schnizzle. Luigi, baby, how are yous? How is yous? Always good to have you here. Okay, let's cut down some of these things. I got so many. All right, I'm going to close some of these down. I got like 9,000 tabs open. There comes a time when you got to just say, geez, come on. Enough with that already. All right, let me see. I'm also working on booking two video game shoots this week. Not be scheduling any sessions this week. Oh, no. Well, poop nuggets. Let's see. That out. Schnibble doodle 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 doo. Okay, I will make sure that we're doing that. Who else is here? Who else is going to say hello today? Because I am going to do a podcast today. And I would love to know who's watching, who's listening, who's here besides Luigi. I know other people will show up. Had a lot of people on yesterday. That was a lot of fun. Get this here. I need to pop open Audacity. Yeah. Get rid of that. Okay, I can see myself in the corner. I am there. Oh boy, that is not a pleasant look for me at this angle. I should turn this way. I've been working out, guys. I've been going to the gym, and I'm like, eh. So, this is gonna go away, baby. See, I just talk like this the whole time. How's that? Alright. So, what else do I need to do? Oh, here it is. Bam! Got it. Oh, sweet! So, it's more people that signed up. Oh, wait a minute. How many got here? Oh, got some new folks popped in. 1, 2, 3, 4. We got like 5 folks that came in to say hi. I love it. I'm very happy to have new people following me. And I will figure out all this stuff on my end. There we go. Okay. So, today I'm going to be talking about your goals and what that means. Because I'm calling it what you want. And why am I calling it that? Well, I'll tell you why I'm calling it that. Because it's what you want. Everybody thinks they want something, right? Whatever it is you want. You think you want something. And it's really not that. It's not that thing that you want. It's the feeling that goes with that. That's what you want. Let me put you guys up here and get a better angle here, because here we are. That's better. Hi, how you doing? There. Hey. And the lighting's good too. Look at that. How perfect is that? So, I'm going to be talking about the goals and how to get your goals. That's why I call it what you want. How to reach your goals like a beast. E-boy. See what I did there? Some of you guys get that. Some of you youngins don't even know what the hell I'm talking about. And that's okay. Might be a shorter podcast, but we're just going to talk about it a little bit. I'm going to write down some notes as I go. And what was that one? I don't even know what I wrote down that one. Cool. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to be talking about today. And today is a bit of a special day. So we are in, as you know, we are in Australia. So we are like a day ahead. So what that means is today here in Australia is my son Declan's third birthday. Happy birthday, baby boy. So very happy about that. So that is today. But right now is actually yesterday in LA. And so tomorrow we're going to be celebrating it as well. So we're about to go celebrate. As soon as I'm done with this, we're going to go to the tallest building here in the Gold Coast. And we were staying directly across the street from it for a few months in this great little apartment that you remember. Some of you guys, if you're new, you don't remember it, but this is a new place. This is a new Airbnb. Thank you, Luigi. Happy birthday to Declan. So this is a new place, right? We've only been here a week and a half, 2 weeks, I guess. I don't even know. A week. But, so yeah, it's a little bit different. But we were, living over one block by the beach. Now we're like two, maybe three blocks away from the beach. I can see the water out there right now. But we were right across the street from this big, big building. And if you had seen Declan on one of the chats here, he probably, if we went outside and he would look up and go, "Eat there, eat there," that means he's going to eat there on his birthday. And today's it. So we're going to take him up to the top of the biggest building and we're going to have some lunch there. And he's going to be very excited. So we're very excited to share that with him. And then tomorrow we'll do a virtual thing with everybody. So there you go, peoples. That's what's happening. So I'm going to go ahead and do a podcast today in about 5 minutes. Five. For those of you that are here, and I'll say it again in a minute, a couple things, actually. So the real, the Reluctant Heroes journey is, I'm going to be opening up for registration again. For those of you guys that know, some of you guys that are on here are probably in it. I got some great testimonials from you guys yesterday. That was fantastic. Thank you for that. If you're on here, I'm going to give you guys a link in the thing here. This is the wait list. I open up registration on the 1st. I think I'm going to do it on the 1st LA time. So it'll be the 2nd here. And thank you, Grupple Nick. I appreciate that. And I will wish Declan all the happiest of birthdays from all of you guys. So here's the link. To hop on and share. Please share with other people. Let them know about the great content that I give you guys in this group. And so thank you, Ashley. I appreciate that. Very, very cool of you. And so I'm going to let you guys know about that, obviously. Keep that going. Having some fun meetings with people and letting them know about that. And I've got some great things that are going to be coming in to the group, which I've talked to you guys about. What was the other thing I was going to talk about? I had something else I was going to say. I don't remember what it is. So that's how I roll on this thing, guys. I mean, I free roll it. I'm just like, hey, whatever. Let's talk about it. So we will be talking about the goals and the feeling behind the goals, because that's really where it all goes today. I wanted to say, for those of you that are on here that know, when I start my podcast, you know, I don't talk to people. I can't, because I'm actually recording here on my microphone. So obviously, if somebody comes in and they're like, "Hey, Spike, what's up? Why isn't he talking to me?" Just let them know I'm doing a podcast and I'll be done. You know, I do it for about 30 minutes and then I will be done. So this one just came to me last night. It was like going, bam, dude, talk about it.
Okay, I'll talk about it.
So that's it. That's what's going to happen here in just a couple of minutes. And we'll see. Isn't this a lovely little backdrop? I mean, look at that. We got little fronzy things, little beach picture. I mean, it's a lovely place. It really is a nice place. And we could look out there. I can see there's a little water fountain out there, a little, water feature thing that Declan loves. And we open up the slide open the doors and the breeze comes in. We can see the waterway out there. And there's a little clock that's close. And it's really cool. Every time it goes off, these little, it's one of those like old, I guess German clocks or something, and the little animals come out and it's ding, 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 ding. And he's like, oh, hear the clock, hear the clock. It's very cool. So, oh, and this is sitting on the desk. This is cool. That's right. That's right. We've got a little Freddie Mercury. Oh, yeah. I picked that up in Melbourne at the at Supernova. When I was at the con, I was walking through. I was looking for some pops, some Funko Pops, like of Shinji or some of my characters, because I could buy them for like $10 and sell them for 50, sign them, or maybe 40. But yeah, I was gonna grab a couple, but they didn't have any, and I saw that, and I was like, oh, dude, I'm getting that for my wife, because she loved the Queen movie, and of course, I grew up with Queen. I mean, I was there when they first came out. I had their first album, second album. I think I did or my friend did. I don't remember.
Huh.
All right, guys. Well, it is time for me to rock and roll with this. Let's do a podcast. Let's talk it up. So remember, if anybody comes on, just let them know, hey, actually, you know what? I'll do this. I'm in the middle of a podcast, so I can talk after I'm done. Listen up and enjoy. How's that? Let me spell that correctly. Okay, let's see how this goes. Are you ready? Me too. Now, I'm going to be talking down this way a little bit. So I'm actually going to put you guys down here now, because I am going to be on the microphone. So, man, I'm going to be a little hunched over. If I had another thing to put this up on. You know what? Maybe I do. Hold on. All right. Some of you guys asked me about some of the books that I'm reading, that I read. This one I read, Hungry, all about Renee Redzepi. That was really cool. But the books that I read, the self-help and personal growth, Dollars Flow to Me Easily, great book to read. I'm reading currently Ego is the Enemy, very good one. And something that has nothing to do with it, but it's very interesting, The Wisdom of Tea. So there you go. I am learning so much. Every day. There we go. Let's see. Be better to put you guys here now. I'm in the microphone. I can talk to the microphone here. Raise it up a little bit further. There we go. A little bit better. Yeah. Oh, it just wants to go that way. Oh, yeah. Oh, really? Take that, you? Okay. So, let's clear everything out. All right, we are ready to boogie, boogie, boogie and a woogie. And hit it. Oh, I forgot to check. Check, check, 1, 2, 1, 2, check, check. Okay, here we go. We're talking about blah, blah, blah. Great, got it. I think it's about right. Hello, hello, everybody, and welcome to the Mind Scramble Pod. Wow, ooh, sorry, guys. That was. How do you turn this down? I wonder if I could turn it down here. My apologies. I might turn that down a little bit here. Oi, oi. Mic. It's all the way up. Okay. Try that again. Okay, everybody. Welcome, welcome, and welcome to the Mind Scrambler Podcast. I am your host, Mike Spencer, and I have a fun podcast today. I am calling this one, What you want. Some of you guys understand exactly what that is. Some of you guys think I'm out of my freaking mind. Well, that is from the Beastie Boys, one of my favorite groups growing up. I mean, they were part of the soundtrack of my school days. And it got me thinking. I had a divine download yesterday. It was like, I just heard that. I was like, so what you want? And I went, oh, goals. Goals and goal setting. Everybody wants something, right? And I was thinking, well, so how do I teach people? How do I train and coach people how to get the things that they want? And so I started taking a couple of notes, and I was thinking about it, and I said, the big part of goals, things that you want, it's not the thing itself that you want. It's like, oh, I'm going to win this trophy. You're not going for the trophy. You're going for the feeling of winning, the feeling of being the winner, being the best, or the feeling that you have accomplished something. So whatever your goal is, it can be anything. It doesn't matter what it is. But think about it. The thing that you are going for many times is simply a symbol of what it is you want. And it's really, truly the underlying feeling, the emotions, the sense of well-being that you get underneath. That's what you're actually going for. So I wanted to talk about that and how to question it a little bit, because if you're not clear on that, sometimes you kind of lose it. It's like saying, I want this car. So for example, I want a Cadillac Escalade. That's my car, right? That's going to be my dad mobile. If I ever get back to the States and buy a car again, because I sold my car because we only need one in Burbank, because I walked to most of the studios. And then, of course, we're down here in Australia. So some of my podcasts are not in order. Some of them I find some old ones and I throw them out. So the one that's probably right before this one, I may have done, you know, a couple months ago. So today, it is right now, it is 7:27 in the U.S. and 7:28 in Australia, which means today is my baby boy's third birthday. He turns 3 today, so I'm very excited about that. And our goal is go to the top of the biggest building here in the Gold Coast of Australia, where I currently, we currently reside since March. And yeah, we're going to go celebrate way up high, and it's going to be quite amazing. But it's not, again, it's not about, that's not the goal. It's the feeling we're going to have when we're up there, the view we're going to get, and how much fun that's going to be. So anyway, so that is where I am, and we're in the middle of the COVID craziness, etc. And we are in Australia, and we have been here for some time, and we'll probably be here for some time to come. We really have no idea, but we're open to the adventure. And, you know, like I said, if you guys heard my talk on expectation, hey, I don't expect anything, and I expect everything. And I'm totally happy about it, because this is what's going on. I expected one thing. We got this other thing. And you know what? Turns out we're basically in paradise, in one of the safest places on the planet at this moment. And where we were going to be going home is nuts. So there you go. Was this my goal? Was it what I wanted? Not particularly, but you know what? Now that we're here, we're kind of like rethinking our goals, going, you know, what if we stay here? What if we were to become Australian citizens? It's a new paradigm that we haven't thought of before. And so that kind of changes our goals, changes our outlook. So, and it changes the feeling of what it is we want, what it is we thought we wanted. So anyway, to get back on track with the goal setting, well, I was saying the Cadillac Escalade, that is my car. That's going to be my dad mobile. That's what I want. And I know that it's not that I want a Cadillac Escalade. It's that I want that as my feeling of being a success. That's part of the trappings. It's like, it gives me a feeling of being successful, being a good father, being able to drive my children and other people's children around in safety and comfort. And it just, it makes me feel better. And it's funny because actually when I talk about it, Kim says, she's like, you shift. It's like, you shift. You walk a little taller, you know. You've got a little more pep in your step kind of thing. That's what a goal does. And it's when you get that goal, you get closer to that goal, it just intensifies. But see, here's the part where a lot of people get tripped up. They think that goal, whatever it is they want to get, they're going to get the feeling then. And it's actually, that's backwards. You've got to get the feeling first. Let me say that again. You've got to get the feeling first. You have to get the feeling first because that feeling is what is going to propel you. That feeling of the excitement and that creation of the story that you want to have, that means you get that escalator, you get that job, or you get that whatever it is. You're like, oh, when I get that, then I will have that. Wrong. That's not how it works. You have to have that in order to get that. You have to be the person who gets that goal, because otherwise you're never going to get that goal. Think about it, because people think, oh, I'm going to get that goal and then suddenly I'll be all these things. You have to earn it. You don't get the trophy and then become the winner. You become the winner, then you get the trophy. Think about that. You got to become the winner. So you have to become that person. So I have to become that person who can afford the Escalade, who can handle driving the Escalade, who deserves the Escalade. So what is in your life? What is your Escalade? What is your goal that you need to deserve? You need to become the person that has that goal. You have to become the person that deserves whatever it is, whatever trappings that having that goal or finishing that project, etc. You've got to become that person who deserves that. And that's where people kind of lose it. They're like, I see my goal. And it's like, I want that goal. And as they live their lives, that goal keeps moving and moving and moving. Why? Because they're not becoming the person to bring it closer and closer and closer. They just keep saying, I want that goal. I want that goal. Okay, well today, what have you done to get you towards that goal? What have you done to train yourself to become that person who deserves that goal? What did you do today? Write it down. See, you should be at the end of the year, there should be 365 things that you have done to get you closer to your goal, or you're not serious. Because people want to think about it and say, well, we'll see. You know, they're like, well, I sure hope I get my goal. Well, hope is not a strategy, people. Hope will not get you there. Habits will get you there. Training will get you there. Dedication will get you there. Consistency will get you there. And to get there, you have to become that person here, wherever you are right now. That's your starting point. That is where you're going to become that person. This is the part, this is the platform, this is the foundation that you're working from to get out to where it is to find what you want. So are you ready to do the work to get you there? And that's the question you have to ask yourself. So the first question I'll ask people, and it's interesting because whenever I coach somebody, I say, okay, what do you want? That's the question. What do you want? What you want? And many, many times, they may have a kind of an idea of what they want, but it's not specific. It's not what's called a SMART goal. And there's a whole specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time-bound. I have an issue with the time-bound thing. But anyway, that's a way to put goals, to get goals put together. And they may not have a very, very specific goal in mind. That's the first step. We got to figure that out. But what they'll do is they'll say, they'll start telling me all the things they don't want. Well, I don't want to end up broke. I don't want to have this happen. I don't want to have this, that. Well, what they're doing is they're telling themselves all the things that they don't want, and their subconscious mind is going, okay, yeah, you don't want that. Great. You get more of that because you said want that, because the subconscious mind doesn't know the negative side of it. And if that sounds weird to you, think of it this way. If I tell you don't think of a blue elephant, what do you think of? Blue elephant. Your subconscious mind is the same way. You know, I don't want to get fat. Okay, get fat. I don't want to be broke. Okay, be broke. That's what it hears. So you've got to be very specific on the things that you want. So when you say what you want, you say, okay, I know this is what I want. And you, once you figure out that goal, you go, okay, now you know what you want. You say, like, I want this Cadillac Escalade. Okay, great. So what is the payoff? What is the feeling that you will have driving that Escalade? How would you stand or sit? How would you just be? Would you be cooler? Would you be stronger? Would you be smarter? Would you be richer? What would you be? And you look there and you think about those feelings and you can feel them now. And that's your connection to get you to what you want. That feeling is, it's a vibration, it's a frequency, it is on the wavelength of what you want. And that's how quantum physics is starting to, this is all scientific stuff, it's not woo-woo anymore, guys. You are on the same wavelength and that the level that will get you towards your goal. If you feel it first. So, put it this way, there's a guy, they call him the Billion Dollar Man, Jay Abrams. He is probably the best marketer in the world. And he has helped so many companies just make billions and millions of dollars. And he had a very interesting way of doing it. Just a little quick side note. He would say, all right, so you're in this industry. You're in this industry and you make screwdrivers. Okay, great. I want you to go study how popcorn is made. Or, you know, oh, you were in this industry and you were a veterinarian. Great. I want you to go over here and I want you to study motorcycle maintenance. It's like, wait, what? That makes no sense. Because what he'd do is he would study these things that had seemingly nothing in common, but you would see different ways of doing things. And you'd go, wait a minute, what if I tried that over here? Because nobody else was thinking that way. And he did that over and over again. And people were like, oh man, I, because you get stuck doing something the same way over and over again because that's the way it's done. Well, if this is the way things are done, common sense here, guys. If things are done the way they are done and 99% of the people fail at what they're doing, then do you want to continue to do things the way everyone does them? I don't. This is why I do things differently. You know, this is why I decide to hang out in Australia rather than come home and play it safe. This is why I'm doing a podcast every day. Well, a podcast, but at least this is why I'm chatting with people every day and teaching and training and doing the things that I need to do because it's different. It's a little something different, right? So today, what I want to say about Jay Abrams is looking at things from a different way. He said, when somebody goes to Home Depot to buy a hammer, they're not going to Home Depot because they want a hammer. They're going to Home Depot because they want to get a hammer, because they want to hammer in a nail to put together two boards to make a deck to maybe have friends and family over and raise their children and have that feeling of community and family and security and love. They're not going to Home Depot for a hammer, they're going to Home Depot for love. That's why you do anything. Why the goals that you have, why are you going for those goals? You're not going for the goals. I used to play tennis. I used to love play tennis. I wanted to go to Wimbledon and all that when I was young. I was like ranked 11th in the state of Oklahoma when I was like 13 or something like that. Big whoop. But I was on the path, and I was like number one on my high school tennis team for, you know, 2-3 years. And I really, really wanted to play. And I would compete. And I went, I had a whole bunch of trophies. I wasn't competing for the trophies. I was competing for the feeling of being the best in that tournament. So if you can switch it around and you say whatcha want, you want that feeling. It's the feeling of what you want. You have to get that feeling first. And the way you get that feeling is through training. That's how you get coaches. That's how you read the books. That's how you figure it all out, because you need to be on that path that is aligned. You have to align that feeling in your heart with the feeling you're going to have at the end of the goal. That's where it matters. That is how you get to your goal. You get there first. Before you ever get to the goal, you have the feeling, because the feeling is what you want at the end. So that feeling propels you. It's like a mission statement. Like, my mission statement is, I want to bring inspiration and laughter to millions. Well, cool. You know, I can only do so many arm farts here. But, and maybe some people will laugh, and some people will think, oh my God, he is just such a child. Yeah, so what? Farts are funny. Hey, ask my 3-year-old. We laugh our asses off. But that's what I want to do. This is why when I do a podcast and nobody's there, or you know, I do a stream or a training and nobody shows up, then, you know, I'm like, okay, it doesn't matter, because it's still out there, and I'm going to still release it, and I'm going to still put it out on YouTube and Twitch and other places, because somebody's going to watch it someday, and somebody's going to be inspired. And it could be tomorrow, it could be next day, it could be years down the road. Somebody could watch an old video of mine, and this happens from time to time. They'll watch an old video. It's like, this is like 10 years ago. And they'll be, wow, that was really inspirational. Thank you for doing that. It's still up there. It's evergreen. So that is part of what drives me. This is why I'm here doing this right now, because I know what I'm talking about, and I know I can help somebody. And some of you are listening right now thinking, you know what? I really never thought of it that way. And that's the thing. People don't think of things other ways. They think of things the way it has been hammered into them by the mainstream media, by their family and friends and neighbors, by, you know, oh, they say, well, who the hell is they? I got a podcast on that one. Go check it out. It's called Them. Who the hell are they, and why are you listening to them? Because they don't exist. You have to think about things a different way. It's like, Robin Williams and the Dead Poets Society, when they said, look at things from a different angle. I used to do that literally when I was working on properties, when I was flipping houses and things. When I didn't know what to do, I would sometimes I would lay down on the floor and look around, or I would stand up on a chair and look around, and I would go from different angles and go, you know, and just say, listen to the house. What does it want? And I would just look, and I'd feel the flow. And I'd get an idea, oh, you know, I take out that wall right there, then we've got this thing here, da, da, da. It's all in perspective. So you need to get on the perspective of having the feeling before you have the thing. And that's hard for some people, because they don't understand that. They like they put the cart before the horse, if you want to call it that way. They say, well, you know, I'll get that thing. And then they don't do the things to become the person that deserves to have that thing. It's like athletes work every day. We never hear about the athletes that come in second, third, usually. Most of the time, never hear about them. But they busted their ass just as much, maybe even more than the guy who won. How do you deal with it? I don't know. But they all are world class. Which is number three. And the Olympics, who came in number four? I don't know. Nobody cares. But that person worked their butt off, just like everybody else. And they were aligned, but they didn't quite get to what they wanted. And that person who stands on winning the gold medal, they became that person who deserved that gold medal. And they felt it. I'll guarantee you, most of the people who are successful, not all, but many, they will tell you, they visualize, they see it, they have been there. They already know. They say, that goal, here's what I want. I want, you know, this, keep with the Escalade analogy. So I want that Escalade. So what am I going to do? I'm going to think about that. I am sitting in it. I can smell it. I can feel it. I turn on the radio or turn on, you know, for an Escalade, man, I have like DVDs and video games and all the stuff in the back, you know. It's like I'm hanging out in the back of my Escalade. I'm playing some old Crash Bandicoot because it's fun, you know, because I like it. And I'm feeling it. I feel it. And I'm visualizing that moment. And then when it comes, I'm like, oh yeah, I deserve this. I felt this over and over again. It's time. This is perfect. So it doesn't feel weird. It doesn't feel like, oh my gosh, I don't deserve this, because that is not aligned. That is not the right frequency. You go, oh yeah, you step right into it. You go, yeah, oh, I totally deserve this. It's awesome. And that's what I'm telling you to feel today. When you figure out what you want, you have to figure out how it makes you feel to actually have that. And that's a hard one for some people, because they don't understand how to visualize, because the mind does not know the difference between something real and something vividly imagined. And this is why people have so many issues with our court systems, when people say, no, this happened, this is how it happened. And then there's video that says, that is not how it happened. I know that's you right there, and this is what happened here, and you're telling us something completely different. And you're like, well, I would swear that that is exactly what happened. That is what I remember. So what we remember sometimes is not what actually happened. And as time gets older and older, people are like going, you know, oh yeah, I remember it vividly. No, you don't. You're remembering something that never happened, but you've played it over in your head over and over again, so you think it did. And that is something that can work to your advantage. You play something over and over again that is great, that is amazing. You go up on stage in front of thousands of people and everybody's cheering you on. That feels amazing. I visualize that before I go on stage. There's 10 people out there. I'm thinking, I got 1,000 people out there and they're loving it. I'm like, hello, babies. How are you? You know, I feel it. It's a feeling. You feel first, then you get the goal. I'm gonna keep pounding that into you. You gotta feel first before you get the goal. So how do you do that? So what you do, there's a couple of different ways you can do that. You visualize, like I said, you visualize, you just think. There's nothing more powerful than the human imagination. It is absolutely phenomenal, and it works. People can heal themselves with their imagination. They visualize healing. I'm working on a project right now with my body. There's something that I'm healing. And, you know, I've got a year, I'm thinking. I'm gonna give it a year, and I'm going to just keep focusing and focusing and focusing. And I want to see my progress in a year. So, and it's going to happen. But the point is, you imagine, you visualize. And you visualize to the point where you feel it, to where you feel the feelings, you know, you think about it, you play some music behind it, something that motivates you and gets that, gets the blood pumping, gets the hairs on the back of your neck going. You're like, yeah, all right, this is what it feels like. If you know, like the Escalade, what song are you going to play when you get in that car? You know, what's the first song you're going to play when you're driving off in that thing? It's like, oh yeah, I'm going to play this song. So we'll hear it in your head. Play it in the background while you're visualizing this, you know. Get that new car smell. They have sprays for that. You put it in the air. You're like, yeah, I can feel this. Man, feel it, feel it, feel it. That's imagining it and going for it and feeling that feeling. And if you have a hard time doing that, sometime in your life, could be when you were 3, you've had that feeling. You've done something and it felt really good, that you accomplished something, or you know, you earn something, or you won a race, something along that line. And you can tap back into that. If you can remember that, you can tap back into the feeling. You go back to it, you think about it, you visualize that, and you remember the feeling. You go, oh wow, I remember that feeling. It was so, ooh, and you get goosebumps. And you go, yeah, that's the feeling. Now think about the thing that you want, the goal. And you basically transfer that feeling onto that. So you get that feeling. Because that frequency, that vibration that you have when you're feeling that is what's going to lead you to your goal. You know, when I say I want to inspire and bring laughter to millions, I see myself on that stage. I can see it right now. I walk out on this stage and there are people everywhere. I can't even see them all because it's far. There's a lot of people, thousands. And I come out and I say something silly. And they're like, yeah. I'm like, how you doing? Ah, you know, big microphone. And I've got people out there and they're cheering for me. And I'm going to deliver a message that is going to uplift them and help them and inspire them and make them laugh. I already know it. I already see it and I can feel it. I got goosebumps right now. The hair on the back of my neck is like, ooh. And it's awesome because I know it's going to happen. And I'm working every day to become that person, to become better, to become a better podcaster, to become a better speaker, to become better with keeping my message on track, whatever it is. And I'm visualizing it, I see it, and I feel it, so I know I'm earning it every day. So I'm urging you to do the same. Find out what it is you want. Pick one thing that you want. Go into the future, look at it. Imagine being there. Imagine the feeling of having that thing or achieving that status or completing that project, whatever it is you want. How are you going to feel when it's done? That's the question. That is the real answer to what you want. It's not the goal. It's the feeling that you're going to get when you have that goal, that emotion that will well up. You might have a tear in your eye. You know, when my baby boy was born, I had envisioned it and I knew it was going to happen. I had no idea the power it was going to have over me. I had no idea the emotions that were going to well up inside of me and how amazing it was going to be. I visualized it and it was 10 times better than that. So sometimes that goal is, wow, so much better. So much better. The feelings are amazing. So when you tap into it at the beginning, have that feeling, become that person who deserves to have that thing that you want, you're going to feel it. And you're going to be aligned and on the same frequency with what it is you want, which means you become magnetic. And it starts to come to you because that is the way the universe works. You get aligned with it, be authentic, and it comes to you. And there it is. That's the big secret. That's the secret in the secret. There is no secret. It's, you know, it does take work, by the way. It does take work. And a lot of that work, most of that work is internal. Most of that work is in here, in your heart, in your mind Mind is one thing. Your subconscious is way more important than your mind. But you have to understand, you tell your subconscious what to do. And the subconscious agrees. Whether it's good, bad, or ugly, if you're telling yourself crappy thoughts every day, then that's what your subconscious is going to act on because that's what you're telling it to do. So think about what you're telling yourself. Is it getting you towards your goal? Is it giving you that feeling? Because if you think, oh, Cadillac Escalade, that's what I want. Here's the feeling. And then 5 minutes later go, I'll never be able to afford it. You just screwed the pooch. You're done. It's not helping you. You have to believe that you can get that you can achieve that. And I'm here to tell you can achieve anything you want. Jim Fortin, one of my favorite podcasts, he says 99% of everything is 99% attainable. There's certain things that you can't do, right? So people say, everything is possible. Not really, no. But 99% of everything is. And you have to believe it. That belief is gonna move forward. And I did another one, I did a training on confidence. So remember this real quick. The definition of confidence is the feeling that you can have the belief in or faith in somebody or something. That's confidence. Confidence is a feeling. Confidence isn't something you get. It is a feeling. It is an emotion. It is an energetic vibration. Therefore, if you get on that wavelength, you can have confidence that you can get there because you have that feeling that puts you in line with what it is you want. So what you want? You want a feeling. You want the feeling that shows you that you deserve the thing you want. And then you go get that mother like a beast. E-boy. It's See what I did there? I know. It's a lot of fun, right? This is how I roll. Okay, everybody. That was a lot of fun. I hope you got some really good stuff out of this. That is the Mind Scrambler podcast. I am Spike Spencer, and I wish you the best of everything. Please share these podcasts. Give me some comments. Tell your friends. And go do what I say. Damn. Let's go. See you later. Bye-bye. There we go. SR Rocket. What's up, man? What's going on? I was going to see these while studying. Good, good, good. I think this is a good one. I think you're going to like this one. Let me do a little housekeeping here real quick. Noise reduction. Get noise profile. Do. Select all. And then we do this. And then I clip it and I save it and we're done. I got a new podcast. It's just that easy, people. That's right. It's just that easy. So this one will be up on YouTube today or tomorrow. And then it will be out. The actual podcast will be out like September. We'll see. I didn't listen to it because I came here late, so I can't really say I love it or hate it. Well, that's all right. Listen to it again later. It's available. So let's see here. Do clip and go to the beginning. Let's all go to the beginning. Woohoo! There we go. Cut that off right there. What's that? Alright, here we go. There it is. Nice. I'll export it. Which number? I think this is number 31. What? How cool. I've done a lot of these bad boys. Hold up. Let me check. So this one would be 31. Yeah, baby. Cool. 31. So, whatcha want? Bam. All right. What you want? Hold on a second here. Let's see. Well, lost you. You know what? I'll talk to you guys in a second. Okay. It's right here. Number 31. Oops. Mind Scrambler Podcassette. So whatcha? Oops. So but whatcha want? So whatcha want? Okay, I'm gonna put that on. Where am I gonna put that? Podcast. I put it on desktop. It's where I put. Okay, it is done. Beautiful. Pow. All right. Let's see here. There we are. All right. You were saying. SR Rocket. Definitely good listen. Thank you. Like the visualization. Yep. Visualization is huge. I mean, you read books on, you know, success and what leaders have done, and you'll hear a lot of visualization. In the airplane during tests and maneuvers. There you go. Truly relate to that. Good feeling when you tell yourself you're going to nail it, and then you do, of course. Podcast all about goals. Frequently, do you put the podcast on your website? Hey, Gruppelnik. Okay, so on my website at spikespencer.com, they're all there. all of them, all 30. I don't really advertise that because they come out on iTunes once a week. Like another one came out today, and I think it was called Free Your Fracking Filters. I've done no marketing on that whatsoever, no advertising. Go, hey everybody, it's here. So I've been falling back on that, but it came out today. But all of them are there. On as soon as I upload them to Libsyn, I put them on my website. So if you want to listen to them all, you go to my website. But if you want to listen to up to like 24 or so on iTunes, they're all there. iTunes, Spotify, I think they're on all the places. But yeah, you can check that out there. But yeah, the best thing is on my website, they're all there. Like I said, they're not all in particular order. It's pretty much stream of consciousness. So, but there's a lot of good stuff in there. See you later, Luigi. This is personally my first one. I've been tuning in. This is personally my first one, and I've been tuning in. She's on. Cool. Google Play? I don't know. I think so. I'm fairly certain it's on there. So I got a couple more minutes here. So if anybody has any questions about what I was talking about today, now's the time. So yeah. So this one will be out later, and I think I did a pretty good one. I think I got my messages out today. So yeah, now we're gonna go and go up to the tallest building in the Gold Coast and have a little lunch with my baby boy who's 3 today. Yay! Very excited about that. So actually, I'm gonna go ahead and pop off now and say thank you all for hanging out and listening. And once again, let me put in here before I go, I wanna make sure you guys have this link. So thank you very much. Thank you very much for the blessings from my son. Right here, this is for the Reluctant Heroes Journey wait list. I'm gonna be opening it up again next week, and I'll only have it open, registration open for 1 week. So if I get you on the wait list, you guys will have first crack at it. I will email you and say, okay, it is open. Let's do this. And it is, some of you guys have been on here and know how valuable the group is. It's $11 a month, it's nothing. And there's some coaching. I coach in there. I have challenges for you. And a lot of people are getting a lot of really good results. And it's for, like, what, a couple of cups of coffee? Please. There you go. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much. And please share that link about the wait list. And just share that you got some good information from me here. And please go to the podcast on iTunes and leave me some reviews. I would really appreciate that. The downloads and the reviews are so helpful. Thank you guys so much. Have a wonderful day. I'll see you later.